All right, so we went over a little bit of some of the things that you can do with Angular. In this video, we're going to go over a few different things. We're going to go over Angular filters and ng-repeat, actually. I just wanted to do a refresher of what we just learned, which is directives and expressions. So directives are essentially just attributes that you're going to add, they're each doing different things, right? So ng-app is defining the scope of Angular. NG controller is where our data is going to be stored in a different place, and then we can use that. And then NG model is what you can use to bind it. That along with expressions. So the next thing that we're going to go over is actually Angular filters. So for this, I just want to show you guys. In this controller page that I have, my control. If I want, I can say ng controller or app.controller, and then this one I'm going to call cost control. And then in here I'll create my variable. We'll say price equals 58. Cool. So I now have a second controller with different data inside of it, right? But the thing is that, on a small scale, it shouldn't really be a problem. But like, if we have like a lot of stuff that we need to do, then you probably, as far as organization wise, it's better to just create a new file. So I'm going to copy this, and I'm actually going to create a new controller file. So let's go back to our controllers page. I'm going to say new file. And I'm going to save this as costcontrol.js. And then I can paste it. And I'll go ahead and copy the script tag. And I'll call this costcontrol. So now we have our second controller loaded up, or linked up. Let's look at what we have here. We have cost control, right? So I'm going to put this into this div because that's what I want it to be able to affect. That's what I want it to apply to. And then I'm going to say, same way that we did the other things, I'm going to say h1. But instead, I'm going to actually say price, and then I'm going to make an expression. And I'm going to say price, and essentially the or symbol, and then currency. So what this is going to do is, let's take a look actually. So Angular has built-in filters, and we can do that. It has just a ton of them. This was just a quick example of different filters that you can use. They're kind of like string methods, I guess, in JavaScript. That would be a good example of what they're like, because you have uppercase, lowercase, number. You can sort by date. You can sort by limit to. You can sort by JSON. You can sort. You can do like apply all of these different filters, and there's a giant list of them on W3 Schools, which you guys should go through and check out. I haven't memorized all of the filters, but there's definitely a lot that you can use, and it just makes your life, a lot easier. Another thing, the next thing that we're going to go over is going to be ng-repeat. So if you guys know in JavaScript, you have to code out everything. You have to, essentially, you would create a, if you have an array of objects, you would create a for loop and have the for loop loop through the, loop through that array of objects, right? With ng-repeat, we're actually removing a lot of the logic behind it, so you don't have to create for loops and do all of that. You're essentially just gonna attach ng-repeat in an expression, and it's gonna be able to loop through everything. So I'm gonna go ahead and, I can leave that actually. I'll create another div. And I haven't created this controller yet, but I'm about to, so it's okay. We'll say users control. Inside of that, I'm going to create a UL, then I'll say LI, oh, for this one, I'm going to say ng-repeat equals. And now I'm going to jump back over to our other thing where you need to create the new controllers thing and map out the data, and then I'll come back and put this info in. So for controllers, I'm going to create one more controllers file, and I'll save it as userscontrol.js. In here, I'm going to say app.controller users control, because that's what we named it on the other end. And then I'm going to say function scope. And then in here, I'm essentially going to create an array of objects. And I'll call it username. Isaac, password, and I'll do the same thing, password 2. Password 3, cool. So, pretty much, I think that pretty much has everything that we're looking for. Now we have an array of objects right here, and we're going to reference that using user control. And then let me go ahead and link that. UsersControl.js, and then now we can build out the ng-repeat. I'm going to enter multi-view again, just so that you guys can see what's going on. So now, in ng-repeat, I'm going to say x and users. So when we say x and users, this is essentially looking for users, the variable name, and this is what it's going to loop through. And then in here, we're going to go ahead and create an expression, and I'll say x username plus space, and as you guys see, there's also some concatenation with this too, and then x.password. So another thing that you guys should know is that the x, that can actually be whatever you want. I'll show you guys that in a second. But let's open this up and see what it looks like. So now it's essentially looped through our array of objects and displayed it. And what would be like the JavaScript version of that? You would have to create the for loop and do, you know, users.length or whatever. So I also wanted to show you guys that the X is not really what matters. Like, I could put anything here. I could say hey and users. And it's still going to do the same thing when I open it up. Yeah. So it's kind of like a reference point. So we'll leave it at X for now. But yeah, that's essentially how you can loop through data with just using ng-repeat, right? This all looks the same. It looks pretty similar to JavaScript, right? If you're looking at it from right here, this looks pretty similar to what you would do in JavaScript. And instead of doing the for loop, you're going to do ng-repeat. X and users. So, super useful, and I hope this helped.